Welcome to another edition of Wildcat Weekly with head coach Sean Miller. Cats are home this week. They got Utah on Thursday night, Colorado on Saturday afternoon. After the Oregon trip, coach, you look back, you had four freshmen making their first Pac-12 road trip. You had three other transfers that were on the road for a Pac-12 road trip for the first time. What lessons do you hope that those guys in particular can take out of that trip for the future?
Well, you know, winning in conference play is never easy. Winning on the road in conference play, I think, takes on, you know, an added element, familiarity, comfort. You know, you're playing against players and teams, sometimes coaching staffs that, you know, they're hungry, they're desperate. And there's amazing familiarity between programs, you know, coaches that have coached against each other for, 6 years, 5 years. And so with that, you know, conference play takes on different meaning. There's more accountability, details matter even more. And I think, you know, sustained effort where, you know, you have to play the game with incredible energy and emotion, not just for portions, but for the entirety. And that's why, you know, depth is important and veteran play is important. But, you know, I appreciate you pointing it out because it's true. We have a lot of new faces, and the three freshmen, Zeke, Nico, and Josh, are all doing the best they can, and they're all having great freshman seasons. Christian Coloco, our fourth freshman, is coming in and I think improving and really giving us a shot in the arm. But, you know, at the end of the day, that is who our team is, and there's a lot of young teams in college basketball, and we have to bounce back and get back into the winner's circle.
Zeke Nagy has been incredibly consistent in his first year. He took a season-high 14 shots at Oregon State. Where would you like to see that number on a game-by-game basis in terms of his field goal attempts?
Well, I think if you combine his free throw attempts and his field goal attempts, 20 is a great number for him. You know, and in some games, you know, Zeke is able to get to the free throw line 6 to 8 times. And, you know, he is a high-percentage free throw shooter. He's checking in right about 80%. Like in the last 5 games, he has 4 turnovers, and he's, you know, he's playing about 32, 34 minutes per game. For a freshman big to only have 4 turnovers, that's a remarkable stat in and of itself. But we've talked about it, Brian. His rebounding is improving. He's always had a knack for the ball on the offensive end, but he's getting more and more defensive rebounds per game. I think right now, you know, he's really moving towards averaging a double-double. So I can't think of any reason to not, you know, be able to get him the ball in scoring position. And in Zeke's case, you know, it's not always on the block or in the lane. You know, you can hit him on a roll. You can hit him in the middle or high post against the zone. And we're continuing to develop and teach him to move more because it's easier to get a guy the ball when he's a moving target. And, again, you know, there's steps with freshmen. I think you get better at this, and then all of a sudden you start adding this to what you want them to improve on. But I don't think anybody can doubt the terrific season that he's had to this point. And we're hoping that with continued health that he can just continue to add to what he's doing, because he's, from a numbers perspective, you can put his production up against maybe any freshman that's ever played here. And as we both know, that's quite a group.
All right. You've got a Utah team coming to town on Thursday night with the Pac-12's leading scorer in Timmy Allen at 6'6". What makes him so dangerous?
Well, he's more of an interior player, even though he's a wing. He's got a great skill set close to the basket. He has a knack of getting fouled, and he also has a knack of scoring over bigger players. Utah is very creative and clever in the way they try to get him the ball. But a year ago as a freshman, I really felt he was one of our conference's best players, and he's done nothing but add to that. You average 20 points per game. That's what Trace Tinkle does for Oregon State, and he's certainly a player of the year candidate in the Pac-12.
What is unique about Utah's offense? I think you mentioned before that Larry Krystkowiak has some unique things, some different things that his teams do offensively that maybe you don't see week in and week out.
Well, they really execute. You know, it's like blocking and tackling. You know, it's the scheme, but it's doing those two things well in football, basketball. It's, you know, Utah sets great screens. You know, they wait on the screen. The ball moves. There's a lot of players on the court who don't dribble a whole lot. The way their personnel is set up, they have a couple guys that the one thing they do really well is shoot the three-point shot. So when they're in the game, you have to know where they're at, and their spacing is good. But they have a good feel for offense. Larry is, I think, one of the game's best. They have a good pace. They move it. They get their best players' shots. You know, coming out of timeouts, last plays of games, first plays of the second half, got to be on alert when you play them because they really do execute.
All right, Cats and the Utes coming up Thursday right here at McHale Center, and we'll see you next time on Wildcat Weekly.